Welcome. Today is December 1st. There's several of our members are away today, as in the Zen tradition, this week, the first week of December, is traditionally the week that we hold the most, intensive of the year. It's called Rohatsu, which is a Japanese word that means the 8th of the 12th, meaning that it climaxes on the 8th day of the 12th month, Jodo, enlightenment or awakening day. My teacher Genjo, who runs Choboji in Seattle, runs a Rohatsu session every year. So Reverend Doshu is down there, and Hoyu's down there, and Egan's down there, and Terry's down there. I think there might be someone else down there too. But that's why there's so few robes in the Zendo tonight. And I just wanted to commend the officers tonight, the Jikijitsu and the Shoji, and the Shoshoji and the Joko and the Ino as well, because basically they're running pretty shorthanded. And that kind of just makes me want to encourage you all to just sort of look around you and recognize what we've got going on here in this community. This morning, I was beginning to sort of type an email to start one of my least favorite activities in Zenwest, which is our quarterly fundraising drive, which, obviously we do every quarter. That's why it's a quarterly fundraising drive. And as I was getting ready to send it out, I started getting all of these emails in myself. And I came to learn that apparently December the 1st is Giving Tuesday. Did you know that? I didn't know that. And it really struck me as odd because I thought, wow, didn't we just have like Cyber Monday and Black Friday and all those? And I thought, that's crazy. So we have this opportunity or this encouragement to give to charities, but it's after we've blown all our money on 60-inch television sets. So I thought, oh, this is, maybe we should flip this around. But every time I move into this sort of phase of practice of the fundraising drive, first of all, I have to sort of wrap my head around it. Because there is a part of me, the sort of prideful part of me, which absolutely hates it. The reality is that I am an employee of Zenwest Buddhist Society. My whole livelihood, my food, my rent, everything is paid for by a salary paid from Zenwest Buddhist Society. And so when it comes to looking at the budget for a year of practice at Zenwest, a significant part of it, nearly half of it really, is my own salary. So when it comes time to do fundraising drives every quarter, I'm confronted with the fact that essentially I'm begging for my own livelihood. And this is terribly embarrassing. And ego grinding. And then I remember that for a Buddhist priest, this has always been the way that we've made our livelihood. From the earliest times in the Buddha Sangha, the priests went out on the street with their bowls and begged. And this is considered an essential part of practice in the Buddhist tradition. That practice is, for me, each time I ask, I have to ask, what am I doing with the money? What am I doing with the resources? What am I doing with the care and attention that's being given to this community? Am I using it well? Am I using it for the benefit of all beings? So it's a very difficult practice. And every single time we come to this quarterly fundraising drive, I think, I need to quit. I need to go and get a job and like earn my money and not do this begging anymore. It's so terrible. And most of it comes from the fact that I look at the amount that we need to raise every year to keep this endeavor going. And it's daunting. This quarter, to keep going through the first quarter of 2016, I need to raise $7,500 by December 15th before the year-end closure. And that's about average lately for what I need to raise in a quarter. And every time I'm facing it, I think it's just not going to happen. That's too much money. It's too much to ask of people. And what do we do? But then I often end up coming to engage in practice with people. And I come in the door at the chapel and I think, gosh, tonight we're like six or eight regulars down, the people who are the real anchors of this community. And even six or eight anchors down, there's like 25 people coming to practice here. And even six or eight, you know, regular pillars down, we have the resources, the human resources, the practice resources, to put together a period of practice for 25 people that's solid, that people can engage deeply in. I'm sitting here in this room and I'm looking at this character here who's shown up for his first time tonight. And he's connected with us through the podcast. He's from Alberta, Eugene. Say hi to Eugene, everybody. Hi, Eugene. And so this is one of the things that our community puts together through resources from our memberships and through our fundraising drives. And because of this, we have members as far away as Denmark and the Netherlands and Mauritius we have a member in China right now. And they're all able to connect with this body of practice, this Sangha, through the efforts of all of us to keep this thing going. It's miraculous. So, when it comes time for me to ask, we never ask here on a Tuesday night. This is an activity that, again, the members pay for the relationship with the university so that we can have this space, so that we can offer this activity to the general public at no cost, except for parking. Everybody's got to pay their parking. It's because of people who are becoming members and associates of Zenwest. It's because of people who are contributing their resources to Zenwest so that we can make this offering. And when I think about that, and when I investigate my own motivations for keeping this going, for continuing to participate, for continuing to always live on this edge, is it going to happen? Are we going to raise that money? Is this going to keep going? Am I going to be able to feed myself and have a place to live? I recognize that this practice that we're engaged in, and specifically this practice of dana, as it's Giving Tuesday, dana, charitable giving, one of the greatest things that keeps us apart from one another, one of the biggest things that creates separation and division in this world, is our concern about whether or not we've got enough. Whether or not we've got enough and just a little bit more to make us comfortable and okay. Think about it. When somebody asks you, says, hey, have you got a dollar to spare? The first thing, the first person, the first concern that pops in our head for most of the time is, oh, I have some money, but what do I need? How much of the money do I need? Our concern is always starts with us, me. What do I have? What do I need? What do I want? So when we come to investigate this practice of dana, of giving in Zen, in our Buddhist practice, it's not about our time. And it's not about our material resources, and it's not about our money. The greatest thing that we have to investigate giving up or giving over, letting go of, is our fundamental fixation with ourselves. The thing that we have to really confront is letting go of the fear that binds us all the time. The fear that if I do this, I'm going to die. If I do this, I'm going to starve. If I do this, I'm going to not have enough. I'm not going to be enough. We walk through our whole lives, and each and every one of our relationships, we are holding back. Each time we engage with another human being or with an object, we are bound by fear from being completely open, from being completely vulnerable, from being completely loving with that other being, with that other object, with this thing that we call other. So in our practice, when we engage in this kind of formal practice, every aspect of what we're doing is over and over and over again the practice of giving. When we chant, we can chant in a way in which we are keeping a reserve. We're holding back. We don't want to completely extend ourselves because we might look silly. We might do it wrong. We might, someone might think that we're some kind of religious fanatic or something. And so we chant from a position of conservatism. Oh, that's a bad word. We're just holding back all the time. And so our practice in Zen, when we come to chant, is to surrender. To completely give ourselves over without reservation to the activity of chanting. Chanting's hard, actually. It's the same when we walk. It's the same when we bow. Later on, we're going to do full bows, full prostrations. And I want you, when we do these, to investigate how you hold yourself as you do it. Are you able to completely dissolve, completely melt into the activity of bowing? Or is there this sort of awkwardness of like, ooh, God, what am I doing? Are we able to completely give ourselves over to the activity of bowing? These are, again, bowing is also a difficult practice. And so we come back to just this simple activity of sitting. Zazen, sitting and breathing. And the whole practice of Zazen, the whole practice of this seated meditation is simply to give ourselves to the unfolding activity of our lives. Even just this activity of sitting, even this activity of just being here and breathing. If we're aware, if we're paying attention to what's going on, we can experience that there are times where we completely dissolve, we're completely immersed in the activity of this moment, the activity that's unfolding before us as our lives. And there are moments where we are holding back, where we're thinking about past or we're worrying about the future and we're not present, we're not aware, we're not giving ourselves to this activity that's unfolding right in front of us. We're not giving ourselves wholeheartedly to our lives. And this activity of giving, the activity of giving in our sitting, the activity of giving in our walking, the activity of giving in our chanting, the activity of giving when we meet a friend, when we embrace a loved one, when we hold a cup of tea, this activity of giving is fundamental. The Buddha, when he enumerated the paramitas, the perfections, he enumerated dana paramita, the practice of giving, as being the fastest route to awakening. Because when we give this resistance, when we give this separation, this fixation on ourselves, when we give and let go of fear, it is a direct route to experiencing the fundamental completion, the fundamental unification of all things in this vast cosmos. Now, I thought I was going to try and make this talk into a hard sell on why you should all give money to Zenwest, but it ended up being a Dharma talk. That's why we're always struggling, I think. Okay, the bell was clinked just a few minutes ago, and you've all been sitting for a long time. It is my deepest hope that we can continue to engage in this practice together for a long time into the future. But I am going to ask that for all of you who have not considered becoming a part of this community in a formal way, whether that's as a member or whether that's as an associate or whether that's as a patron of our community and of our practice, really, please consider it. We'd love to have you be part of our community, and we really need all the support we can get. So thank you.